Can you get stronger in handling life situations? Of course. But you got to go to work on yourself. You can't blame out there wishing it was easier. Wish you were stronger. Handle the upcoming winters. Don't wish away the winters. That's called naive. Wish for the strength. Wish for the wisdom.
When you live like a warrior, you are vigilant, you are courageous, you are ambitious, you have an expanded vision of yourself. You don't settle for any and everything when you're a warrior. And you got to be in fight mode. You got to be ready to fight. Life is a fight for territory. And once you stop fighting for what you want, what you don't want will automatically take over.
If you've been through a fight, you need to take a moment and celebrate the feeling of victory that I am triumphant. We don't do that enough. We don't celebrate our victories. As soon as we survive something or overcome something, we're off to the next thing without developing the ability to appreciate what we've done. We know that there's going to be a process that we have to go through in order to get to the promise. And in the process, you have to learn how to take baby steps and appreciate this little bit. What we do is look for somebody to celebrate us. And what I want to teach you this morning is you draw into your life a reflection of who you are. If you are abusive to yourself, you attract people who reinforce that. You must then begin to realize that we go through trauma, but we have trial. The problem is sometimes we are in a perpetual state of trauma and we don't take advantage of the trial. We clap a minute and we're through. We ought to have at least as long a celebration as we had frustration. I said we have gone through enough that when we come out, triumph says I made it. Triumph says they tried to take me out and look at me, I'm still standing.
Life is challenging us. In life, when you don't have enough courage, insight, intelligence, that you have outgrown a situation and it's time to move on. Life moves on you. See, we're all basically the same. The only thing that separates us are our habits. You've got something in you. There's a reason that God chose you out of 400 million sperm. You think you're just here to work on a job and then die? You're here to do the greater work. That you want to live like a warrior and die a legend. One of the first qualities of a warrior is courage. You want to live your life from now on with courage. And courage is not the lack of fear. Courage is the willingness to do what it is you need to do, what you are called to do, in spite of the fear. That's why we're told constantly, in the book of life, be of good courage. Most people in a fearful situation, they forget everything and run, but there are few that in a fearful situation, they face everything and rise. Most people, the majority of people, they're not risk takers. They go through life trying to play it safe. There's no safe position in life. You can't get out of life alive. And so this is a time that you want to live your life full. You're here to do something. You've got to live life like you mean it. You have some talent. You have some knowledge. You have some experiences. You've seen some stuff. So when you live like a warrior, you live courageously. You're fearless. When you live like a warrior, you honor your commitment. See, when you decide that you're going to do something, you hold yourself to a higher standard. You're seeking something. You're pushing the envelope. You are challenging yourself. That there's a dramatic difference between being a warrior and being a worrier. And a lot of people are worried right now. Oh, the new virus coming and it's even more lethal and spreads easier. All right. And Got to pay the rent. Got to pay the car note. I learned a long time ago the best way to get back on your feet is to miss 3 car payments. But you don't want to be reckless. You don't want to die for a job. Create something else. Oh, I've got to eat. I could either starve to death or I sign this and risk dying and leaving my family so they can starve without me. You have other options. Don't be limited in your thinking. Come on now. When I look in the mirror, this is not the Les Brown that was in 2020. This is the one that's going to fight like a warrior and die a legend. I want you to have the mindset that you're going to work on yourself. I want you to have the mindset that you're going to improve your health, that you're going to create wealth. I want you to have the mindset that you're going to live an expanded vision of yourself. All you can do is all you can do, and all you can do is enough. But make sure you do all you can do. You want to be fired up thinking and being creative and creating more wealth to protect yourself and to insulate yourself from the ugliness and from the pain that so many people are expressing. When you get up in the morning and you decide to live a courageous life every day, to make a commitment to live your greatest life, get up in the morning in a spirit of gratitude and say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for protecting me, because I'm here because of your grace and mercy. We're not taking a dirt nap. We are here. It's a big deal. This life is to be lived. Life is for living, for being happy, for being productive. Not a life of being average or being mediocre. You've been chosen. You have been chosen for the greater work. People who are spreading confusion and hate, they make it their full-time job to do that. And we have to make it our full-time job to fight back. And so many people, it's easy to get relaxed. After all the celebration, it's easy to get relaxed. There's work to do. You can't be average. Challenge yourself. Just expect things to be great for you. You're going to be consistent. You're going to do the things that you need to do. You want to be a perpetual optimist.